Warning, I swear a lot.
Hi guys, welcome to A Legionary's Life, a game about playing the life of a regular legionary in the Roman Empire, or Roman Republic actually, as the time period would dictate, during the Second Punic Wars. The war between Punics that they did the second time. I joke, of course, the Second Punic Wars was the conflict between Carthage and the Roman Republic, and was widely credited by historians as one of the most deadly and devastating military wars of all time. Whole regions were destabilized, thousands, hundreds and thousands of people were killed or enslaved. It was a big to-do, but a lot of that, I don't think, is really going to be our problem. We are a simple, faceless legionary. One of many. Now the question is, will we become one of those generals who led the campaigns to cause so much damage throughout the Mediterranean way back when? Or will we be another cog in the machine? Or will we just be a faceless casualty on the field of battle? No time like now to find out. Forewarned of warning, this game is unlike most RPGs. In general, it is not designed to put you in a situation where the odds are against you unless you willingly step into it, but challenges should be picked carefully based on your legionary strengths and weaknesses. Combat can be hard at first, but you'll get a lot better once you get the hang of it. Okay, we're gonna die in this video then, that's fine. The same rules that apply to you also apply to the AI. The game will never cheat. I like that. That's good. That is a good way to get on my good side. I'm going to try and do this as organic as possible, you know? Just sort of try and wade headfirst into things and see if I can figure it out due to the by the seat of my own wit. I like that. That's good. Yeah, I'm fine with that, okay. Name, of course, we're foreman. You know, that obviously Latin name. First war lasted for over 20 years. Conflict had been only a matter of time, once the relentless expansion of Rome came close to the huge Carthaginian sphere of influence. A young power propelled by a staggering self-confidence, Rome had most of the Italic peninsula under its control at the time. They were doing pretty well. On the other side was the Punic city of Carnage. They would be so sick if they were called the Carthaginians and their city was called Carnage, but not quite. Carthage, a centuries-old naval colossus dominating the western Great Sea, an insurmountable gap in power and prestige seemed to divide the two cities. Unexpectedly, the Roman Republic emerged victorious, incomplete as the victory was. Building upon its success, the city's maritime territory grew larger and more secure, while humiliating conditions well beyond the actual extent of the defeat were imposed upon Carthage, much like... Oh, it's using that song. Hang on. That's fun. But yeah, much like what the Allies imposed on Germany in World War I, which many speculate is what directly led to World War II. We taxed the fuck out of them and was like, you can have fuck all and fuck you and you guys suck, even though Germany did not start the First World War. But we're getting off topic. Nevertheless, the price was tremendous for both parties. Some say that not even Alexander's conquest devoured so many lives. It all paled in comparison to what was to come. The truce that followed lasted for a generation. You were a child when the situation hovered on the brink of war once again. You still remember the talk in Rome back then, when everybody expected the looming conflict to take place in the distant colonies of Hispania to the west, now that an attack by sea was nigh impossible. The astonishment when the news reached the city is still fresh in your memory. A bold, not yet 30 Carthaginian general named Hannibal Barca had led an army through the lands of the fierce Gauls and across the mountains to the north. The war was here, in Italia, a few hundred miles from Rome itself. Following years were marked by growing panic as reports of whole armies annihilated by Hannibal kept coming. The Punic general was stronger and smarter than anything Rome had ever faced before. Hannibal Barca was a serious dude. Yet his attempt to turn the Italic allies on the Republic was unsuccessful. Defeating him in a pitched battle was beyond the realm's possibility. That much was clear to the Romans. At the same time, he could not lay siege to the capital. The conflict turned into an endless war of attrition. Meanwhile, another war was being fought in Firewall, Spania, crucial to prevent the reinforcements from joining Hannibal. About a year ago, the Roman legions were soundly defeated, and their commanders, proconsul Publius Cornelius Scipio and his brother Gnaeus, were killed. What little remained of the army was now controlling a small patch of land. Even after reinforcements joined survivors, the situation looked more desperate than ever. When the Centuria Assembly had to appoint a new proconsul, only Scipio's son, a young man still in his 20s, stepped forward. No one else wished to take on such a horrible assignment. You, on the other hand, had no choice at all. Right after you had come of age, you were enrolled in a freshly raised legion, part of a second 11,000 strong reinforcement bound to accompany the new proconsul. After a brief training period, you embarked on a long journey to Hispania. Daisy, could you not? That's very loud. Now you've reached your destination and joined what is left of the previous army. Apparently, with the Romans out of the picture, the Carthaginians have divided into three large hosts, each of them at least as big as your current force. They are a long way from your headquarters, committed to securing the whole region. so far away from your home that you can hardly comprehend the distance, with little to no chance of ever seeing your family again, deprived of the most of the rights you held as a civilian, you feel strangely calm as you prepare to face the hardships to come. Interesting, there was a lot of setup there, obviously, because these are real-world events, and I guess the developer really felt the need to just, like, get across what's happening, what's going on. So let's really take a look around. So we're not very strong, but the rest of our stats are decent. We're good with sword and shield, not so good with javelin, longsword, polearm, axe and mace. It would be pretty cool to be a legionary who uses an axe, but, you know, a bit unconventional. Apparently we're in the Hastati line, which is not good, because that was the first line of attack, which they used to soften the enemy up before sending in the veterans. So, that's not great. Obviously we have no deeds, because we've never fucking done anything. Inventory. What do I have? I have a light Celtic helmet. Okay. Pectoral plate, an italic siphos. I've never heard of that type of sword. Is it? It looks like a style of gladius, but I couldn't tell you. And a scutum. We have two javelins. That's neat. Okay. Wow, there's a lot to go on with here. My morale is content, so spend time searching for items. Oh, geez. You know, maybe I don't have any money. Workouts, run, swim, gym. What we're gonna do is we're gonna make a good first impression and volunteer for extra patrol duty. The troops' opinion of me has increased by one. Okay, that was a lot of nothing. Workout. I'm thinking gym. You spend time training in the gymnasium for the extra training. Unfortunately, you suck. Well, fuck, man. I'm gonna do it again. It's all about repetition. Strength has increased. There it is. Overexercise, stress. Okay. I'm just gonna hang around. You spend your little spare time just hanging out. Morale's gone up. Opinion of the troops, because, you know, we're all becoming buddies. Alright, so the troops like me. Extra patrol. Oh, the Kentaurian likes me more now. The thread of your life is spun. Alright, something's happened. You're stuck with an especially aggressive sparring partner this morning. Oh boy. Decius has been here in Hispania since long before your arrival. He is one of the survivors of last year's debacle. So, why am I up against a veteran? His blade has come dangerously close to your throat twice already. Even a wooden practice sword can be lethal when it's used like that. If you hold down control, yeah, you can see your attributes. I'm not gonna complain, because that's weak. I don't know if my stats are really... Come on, spectacular counter-strike, let's go. Your clumsy attack is easily dodged. Decius steps aside and you lose balance, falling to the ground. Well, he didn't kill me. He looks at you, shaking his head. Even the Kentaurian makes a mocking remark. Oh, wow. Oof. Getting back on your feet, you try to shrug off the embarrassment and keep going till the end of the practice session. I got nothing for that, and everyone hates me now. Man, that was quick. Run. Let's go for a run. Let's keep going for a run. Endurance. I want some more quickness. There we go. Thread of your life is spun. Oh, but I'm overexercised. Scaling walls is part of today's drill. This is so interesting. I don't know. I appreciate this does not make for interesting viewing, but I'm very much into this. In front of your line, a ladder is propped against the camp walls. One by one, the men ahead of you sprint towards it and start climbing. Very soon, it's your turn. How do you approach this? We did recently increase our quickness, but it's only slightly above average. I'm gonna go careful. You're looking excessively careful and wimpy. Come on, man! A few more steps and you're over the wall. It's training! If that was an actual siege, yes, you'd need to go quick. But if you're just training, then the initial focus should be getting up the ladder. Once you've established you can do that, then you get faster and faster until you're eventually bounding over the wall. Incidentally, that fucking climbing siege ladder shit, I think is the most terrifying thing ever. Because the first person to go up that ladder is a dead man. Pure and simple. And that terrifies me. Let's play some dice. I've gained one denarius. I hang around. I'm gonna play a board game. I've lost a denarius. I'm gonna play some more dice. I've lost it. Oh god, I'm just losing it all. I used to rule the world. Now in the mornings I sleep alone. Let's try some actual training. It occurs to me we haven't bothered with any training. Solo practice. Sword skill has increased. Excellent. Let's try and spar. Shield skill has increased. Excellent. Sword and shield are up to 30. That's not bad. We could definitely use some more strength, I think. Constitution. That's good, but... Strength. There we go. And now we need to rest, because I don't think there's a lot of time left before the next, attack. Lost a denarius, but the troops like me. I think I'm going to keep playing dice. 3 denarii. I just got paid, so I don't care. The troops like me. That's important, I feel. I feel like that's very important. Just going to hang around. Oh, well, we don't have a lot of time, actually. I'm not going to get my overexercise stress all the way to... Oh, okay, so you already train and work out as part of my routine in order to maintain your combat skills in shape. The exercises you select are extra training and workout sessions. I get it. That's neat. Alright, board game. I lost a denarius again. Time is over. Move on to the next main battle as soon as you feel ready. Not that I have any other options. Can I buy? I can buy and sell. I can't search, though. I could sell, but I can't search. Okay, there is almost literally nothing to do. Let's just see if anything's changed. My inventory hasn't... I'm not wearing shoes. I probably should have tried to buy shoes or find shoes, but it's too late now. The camp bursts into activity as the whole army prepares to leave. You march to the south. It doesn't take long for your destination to become apparent. You are bound for New Carthage, the capital of the Carthaginian colonies here in Hispania. It's a daring move and very risky. We're just going straight for the capital. That is daring. You're not wrong. Several days later, you reach your destination and set camp not far from the city. According to Camp Talk, the closest enemy army is about 10 days' march from here. A long siege is out of the question. You'll have to take New Carthage by storm. Oh, that's always a good idea. You cast a glance at the city walls. Strong stone walls. The thought of fighting your way up there makes your stomach churn. It's hard not to think that you may be looking at the place where your days will end. No kidding. Oh boy. Morale is content. Virtue is normal. The troops like me a little bit, and that might save me. Maybe. I feel like I probably should have focused more on my skills. The next morning, your maniple is among the first to move out of the camp and reach the plain right in front of the city. If what your centurion said is true, the garrison of New Carthage consists of a small mercenary army, possibly 1,000 strong, and of course, the city militia. Well, that's not so bad. There's like 11,000 of us. You're taking your place on the battlefield when all of a sudden, cries of alarm rise from the ranks. Look ahead with a start. The city gate is wide open. A screaming mass, numbering thousands, leaves the safety of the walls, quickly closing the gap with your partially deployed first line. Judging by their scant equipment, they must be the militia. The enemy commander wouldn't risk his precious mercenaries like this. Blood pounding in your ears, you get ready to receive them as the first battle of your life engulfs you. Oh boy. Ooh. When the other side is at the right distance, you prepare to hurl your first javelin. Okay, so he mentioned it was a screaming mass, right? Just like this horde of fucking militia. I think if you just lob a fucking javelin into that mass, you're gonna hit something. Decide to play it safe and hurl your javelin in the general direction of the hostile troops. What an embarrassing throw! Let's hope no one has noticed your pathetic attempt. Come on, man. What song is this? This record. What game is this from? I don't know, I can't remember, but this song is very familiar, sorry. Then, as the other side gets closer and closer, you steel yourself for the incoming fight. Okay, there's a lot to look at here. Wow, there's a lot here, Actually, let's click that, okay? Combat help, wow, there's a lot here. You know what, I'm just gonna kinda wing it, really. Missed. You can hover your mouse over any element of the combat UI to view its tooltip. For example, each selectable action contains a tooltip explaining what it does. Further details are inside the game menu. You can also press Control to show the available hotkeys. Close tutorial. Okay, well that doesn't make a difference then, does it? Let's go for a standard attack. Oh my god. You know what? I'm a coward. Let's go for the groin. Oh yeah! They missed. I'm gonna shield. Knock back with the shield. Ah. And he missed. Gonna go for a quick feint. It failed. And he recovered, apparently. Well, you know what? Let's just go for the torso. No fooling. There we go. That's good. Torso hit again. This seems like it would... Fuck. You missed my leg. That's fine. Let's go for his leg. Missed. Fucking... Oh, jeez. Shield. Knock. Go. Oh, yeah. Okay, I see. Is that like fatigue? Stats. Stance. Top right. Blue. Represents a character's balance and readiness. The farther it falls below 100%, whole circle, the more open and vulnerable a fighter becomes. However, it can regain very quickly and frequently through the recover. And then fatigue is bottom. Okay, so he's off balance, so we should be going for like a fucking neck, a head strike. Or not. He's still not recovered. Let's go for his neck. Missed again. Now my stance is gone. Let's recover. There we go. Alright, both sides are recovered. We're back to the start, although I have a life lead over him and I have more fatigue. So, we're off to a good start. Let's go for his arm. Fuck. Dude, come on, man. He failed. The situation is shifting. You won't be able to keep facing the current enemy for much longer. I see. You can't just fight one guy forever. Let's go for a soft spot. On his torso. Oh, yeah. He succeeded on recovering, but... Ah, and I just lost all my stance. Failed. He keeps missing me, though. I obviously, this guy is supposed to be a bitch. Like, he's not supposed to be hard. Very soon... Right. Eventually, the enemy formation starts breaking apart. Very soon, panic spreads as their wavering turns into a rout. I wounded him. The Carthaginian militia is in disarray. An improvised pursuit is attempted, but your vanguard is stopped at the city gate before it can break in. Alright, well, I would have liked to have killed him, because that would have, yeah, would have been pretty good for my career, but I guess that's just not how the dice rolled. Or maybe my decisions weren't very good. The Centurion beckons to some of your comrades. After a brief talk, they move away from the maniple. You wonder what's going on. The rest of you will storm the city walls. Many ladders are being propped up against the walls, while a constant shower of missiles is raining down from the battlements. The Centurion promised to share a generous portion of his reward, should he manage to be the first man over the wall. I'm going to do my best to help him. You were one of the first to spring forward, determined to open the way. Oh, I succeeded! Quick. Oh, good. You are climbing as quickly as you can. The defenders should have a hard time taking aim at you, but your bold action is still leaving you quite exposed. Defense. One of the missiles hits you. Your health is decreased by 12. You are way too vulnerable here. You are hit again. Your health is decreased by 14. The defender's resistance gets more and more reckless with despair. There's no way to reach the top. At least, the Centurion has noticed your intrepid effort. Thank fuck for that. I got hit twice. The cacophony is unbearable. Cries from both enemies and allies blend with the thuds of stones and smaller projectiles bouncing all around you. Suddenly, the noise begins to dwindle and fade. You can't believe what you are seeing. Hundreds of Roman legionaries are running along the top of the wall, coming from the north. How did they get there? Anyhow, the Punics are melting before them, leaving the battlements unguarded. In the end, your allies reach the gate and open it, letting in the bulk of your legions. Well, we did good, but we've lost just under half our health. There's not much left. I don't have anything in my inventory. There's not much left to do. Except to just keep going. We're going to hit them. You follow your maniple into the city streets. Your orders are very clear. Secure the city by killing everything that meets you in the open. Hopefully nobody will be so ill-considered. Your thoughts are interrupted when a small number of militiamen stand in your path. Oh, boy. I've run out of javelins because I threw my last one. Okay, we're just going to have to close in, aren't we? We're going to start with a fucking shield bash. Resisted. And his feint succeeded. Should I be trying to feint? Because I've got a decent quickness skill. No, apparently I shouldn't be. Apparently that's a terrible idea. Let's just go for that torso hit. No. Let's go for that arm. Oh god, I'm really bad at fighting. Oh, this is not good. Go for the leg. There we go. I just realized I have significantly less health than him, and that's not good. That's not good. Let's go for a shield charge. Failed, and I just lost all my stance. Two of your comrades joined the fight. Thank fuck. I'm gonna recover then. Missed. Oh yeah, they're hitting him now. That's good. At least I won't be killed. Man, they're going for- Oh wow, they're fucking him up. Can I get the killing blow? I would love the killing blow. Oh, I suck! I'm such a bad legionary! It's okay, he's dead, but I didn't get that kill for shit. You look at the militiaman's lifeless body, quick thoughts flickering through your mind. Pity. Draft into service, forced to fight to defend his home. It does ring a bell. You wonder about the people waiting for him at home, never to see him again. Your virtue is increased by 2. An officer yelling out orders brings you back down to earth with a bump. You move on. You keep marching along the streets. As is custom, looting is strictly prohibited until the battle is over. Smart. Stick to the rules and go ahead to the rally point. I'm still not in very good shape, but I didn't actually take a hit in that last fight. Maybe we can complete this campaign and not die. New Carthage is almost conquered, but 500 mercenaries from the garrison are still holding the citadel. The proconsul is looking for volunteers for an assault on this last bastion. He's throwing in a more than doubled loot share. These mercenaries are nothing like the militia you've been facing until now. They may not be the enemy's best troops, they wouldn't have been left here if they were, but they are still professional soldiers. Only the most experienced legionaries are volunteering. No one would blame you if you backed off. Back the fuck off! I am not an experienced legionary. I'm not even a good fighter. And I'm injured. Nope. After a brief but intense struggle, the garrison surrenders. No way that we would have been killed. Even if I was at full health, I would have been hesitant. We got anything on deeds? Oh yeah, shared kill of a militiaman. Well, that's neat. New Carthage has fallen. For the first time in so many years, a change in the tides of war appears within grasp. Morale has increased. You receive your share of the loot. You've gained 80 denarii. Not bad. Your army has obtained an important base of operations. The sea's resources will be invaluable for the rest of the campaign. Hot shit, so how much money do I have now? 170. I dig it. I could really do with some shoes. I hope we find a shop soon. Fighting in a real battle has sharpened your skills. Fuck. Yeah, that's good. I don't have greaves. Let's get greaves. Yes. Alright, in the meantime, I think we need some training. Let's do some sparring. Shield skills increased. Thread of your life is spun. The wheat ration you were given today is blatantly lighter than it should be. Initially, say nothing. If this continues, morale has decreased. If it comes up again, then I will complain. But in the meantime, there could be any reason why we don't have the wheat we need, you know? And screaming about it might not help. Strength has increased, that's good. Threat of my life. You slept well last night. However, you're in for a rude awakening. You have been robbed! I don't have anything. You have lost 40 denarii. I'm not liking this. I want to get my sword and shield skills up to 40. Actually 50, really, if I'm honest. Sword skill. Sparring. 38, 37. Place some dice. Gained a denarii. Hey, it's going well. I've gained money. This was great. Everyone loves me, and I'm richer than I was. More sword skill. I need more. Oh, thread of my life. Your Centurion is quite a Latronculi player. It's not rare to see him spending his idle time playing a game or two of his men, and today it's your turn. He patiently waits for your move as the sun casts his shadow across the checkerboard. Try your best. The game doesn't last long. He's the better player and you hand over his denarii. You have lost one. Well, that's fine, I guess. What is my intellect? Not high, not low. Gonna hang around. Gonna hang around. Gonna hang around. Gonna hang around. Troops like me. Time is over. Let's go. Next campaign. I'm ready. We are stronger now and we have greaves. And we got our javelins back. I'm ready. It's over a year since the capture of New Carthage. Fucking hell, that took place over a year. That's crazy. The Carthaginians have failed to respond properly, hindered by rivalries and lack of cooperation amongst their generals. After winter came and went, Proconsul Scipio sent you on the move once again, marching against the closest enemy army. Led by Hasdrubal Barker, one of Hannibal's brothers, oh boy, the Carthaginians are holding a high two-step plateau near the town of Bacula. Bacula? Baecula? Could be anything, really. A fine defensive position indeed. Dislodging them from there looks like a rather hopeless task, but the proconsul must know what is clear to everyone. The longer you'll stay here waiting, the higher the risk that the remaining two enemy armies will come and crush you. Oh boy, we're in it now, boys. I got all my health back. I'm glad for that. The wait is nerve-wracking, and at last comes the dreaded order. The assault begins. Apparently your skirmishers, the Velites, will have to engage the enemy light infantry holding the lower plateau. Picked units of heavy infantry are ordered to support them. That's certainly an unenviable task. With relief, you learn that your maniple will be kept in reserve. Thank fuck. Oof. The frontal assault is underway when Proconsul Scipio himself takes the lead of half the remaining force as the Carthaginians are busy repelling your soldiers. He leads you around their position. You are climbing the slope at a fast pace when a small group of Numidian cavalrymen approaches and starts harassing you with their javelins. The terrain is far from propitious for a cavalry attack, but they keep pressing you. I mean, my javelins are pretty fucking useless anyway. I'm just gonna throw one at them. I'm just throw it. He barely evades your missile. At last, they recall their attack and ride away. As you reach the plateau, you shake off the wariness and prepare to fight. That was all that training I did. It looks like Hasdrubal has sent reinforcements to his first line, but they are only partially deployed and clearly not expecting you. You charge the nearest group into the flank. Oh, we're in a fight now, boys. When the other side is at the right distance, you prepare to hurl your first and only javelin. I'm going to pick off a specific... I'm just going to throw it into the enemy ranks, you know? Don't mess with things that do work. The javelin disappears into the ranks of the foe. You can't say what damage it caused, if at all, but it must have provided some confusion at least. I like it. As the other side gets closer and closer, you steel yourself for the fight. Fighting! Oh, I've got a buddy with me as well. Which is good, because we're up against a Libyan spearman who's not just a fucking little bitch. You really want to try and pick something with a high hit chance. The highest hit chance possible, because in case you haven't noticed, I'm not a very good fighter. I'm thinking a quick feint would probably be best. Hang on, what does C mean? C, chance to overcome the opponent's resistance. Okay, go for a quick feint. Failed. Well. Look, I'm going to go for a kind of tank-like situation here, where I'm going to distract him and sort of mess with him, and then my buddy can take him out. Except I can't tell my buddy that. He's just going to have to figure it out. Go for another quick feint. Nice. Oh, yeah, he hit him. It's working, because I'm working down his stance, which makes him easier to hit. Yes. Oh, it's good. It's going good. More feints. More feints. Fuck. I think still keep it up. I think this is a good strategy. Just really... I mean, it's seeming like a less good strategy right now, but... He just recovered. But we've got a good chance to hit the torso, and I think we should start going for it. There we go. Keep on him. Yeah, except that did zero damage because of his armor. Well, fuck me, I guess. Keep hitting him. Actually, go for a feint. It failed. I used to be good at these, but apparently I'm not anymore. Try that feint. I'm not a very good fighter. I'm a very bad fighter. Notice this. Soft spot? No, soft spot's even harder to hit with. Shield? Nope. I'm a feint fighter. Just keep going for those quick feints. We need to work down his stance, otherwise we're never going to hit him. This is the only way. Oh my god, me. I am a pathetic fighter, although he is missing, and that is increasing our chance to hit him. But I need to properly break through his stance. There we go, that's good. Oh yeah. And he failed to recover. Now is the time. Let's bypass his armor. Yeah. Keep going for his arm. He's got no armor there. And he failed to recover. Situation is shifting. Keep going for his arm. Oh, we've nearly got him. Maybe we can kill him in time. Come on. Come on. Oh, just one damage. Oh. Yeah, he's dead. I decided to rest for a moment. That's good. Another Libyan spearman. Okay. It's time to start working him down. This is interesting, because I didn't even realize that we would be fighting more than one Libyan, but they're going to keep coming at us until the situation has finished shifting, as it were, and then the fight ends. I imagine in some cases it's like, if you don't kill enough of the enemy, it's like your forces just get overwhelmed because, you know, you didn't pull your weight. In other cases, it's like, by surviving, you just kind of, you know, you win the day because they can't get past you. Eventually, the enemy formation starts breaking apart. Very soon, panic spreads as their wavering turns into a rout. Good shit. Good shit. We've done well. Attacked from all sides, the Carthaginian line is collapsing. Many are taken prisoner, but in the meantime, the bulk of Hasdrubal's force manages to escape. At last, you are ordered to plunder the enemy camp. You set to the task with renewed enthusiasm. More morale. Deeds. We killed a Libyan spearman as well. I'm a team player. This is how I do. The enemy camp is a bit of a disappointment. It looks like the Carthaginians were able to take most of their valuables with them when they retreated. I'm not strong, so I'm going to stay with the large group. While searching, your squad bumps into a small group of men and women. There are a dozen of so. Some rather young. They look and sound like Celtiberians, probably slaves captured by the Carthaginians during their recent campaigns. They must have been left behind when the enemy retreated. You must be careful, for they have even managed to find weapons. The tension rises, partly because of language difficulties. Yeah. Partly because they are afraid of being made prisoners again. Many of them are holding their weapons awkwardly. Should it come to violence, there's only one way this is going to end. Situation is escalating. If you want to do something, now's the time. Virtue, step in to prevent the Oh, fuck. Things are beyond your control. The confrontation is swift and brutal. None of the slaves survive. God damn it. There's little more you can accomplish here. Fuck. Well, I tried, and that's what matters. But I'm also really bad at that. Hasdrubal is heading north, intent on crossing the Pyrenees with the remnants of his army. The proconsul refused to pursue him, and many of the troops are frustrated with his decision, including yourself. your morale is decreased by 2. The Carthaginians you captured are sold into slavery and the revenue is shared among the troops. Scipio orders the Celtiberian prisoners to be released. This will help secure more alliances with the local tribes. Probably would have been good if we hadn't killed those other guys. You've gained 30 denarii. You are haunted by nightmares. The slaves massacre inside the enemy camp still fresh in your memory. God damn it. Fighting in a real battle, sharpen your skills. Fuck yeah. Alright. I'm gonna leave this one here because I'm kind of pressed for time today. But this game is super cool. I actually really like it. Once again, I appreciate it probably does not make for very interesting viewing, and for that I do apologize. But by the same token, I fully intend, and I mean this, I fully intend to make this a full series because I just want to see where this character's life goes, you know? Because you can't obviously just die and then it's game over. I want to see when that happens. But that will very likely happen at a later date. Thank you so much for watching. This game is damn cool. You can go on Steam, you can get it for like £6.50 or something. Very cheap, and it's very interesting. I feel like there are a lot of ways things could have gone that didn't happen because of how my character is built. It feels like there are a lot of specific paths going in many different directions. Hard to say for certain without playing the game more, but we'll probably discover that more together over the next coming weeks, days, whatever. Once again, thank you so much for watching. And whatever I do next time, and hopefully we're a little better at fighting next time, I hope I see you there. Toodles. Goodbye.